from the Cuban, I'm Castro. A presidential residential when I'm back home. It's all speaking about the future on the back roads. Now it's mad shows every time I do a set. I remember trying to call the connect. Sometimes I put my jewels on and reflect. I'm next up, I don't know what happens next.
All right, coming up next, the wait is over. We get to this matchup for the UFC welterweight division title. Well, a long winning streak may guarantee you a title fight in other divisions. Certainly doesn't at 170 pounds. But now, with all the contenders behind him, there is one man left standing. It is this man, the number one welterweight contender, now getting his shot at the dominant champion. And he believes without a shadow of a doubt that he is the best 170 in the world. And he is out to prove it right here, right now. So here we go with round one of this UFC welterweight championship fight. All eyes on the champion as he looks to defend the title yet again. And prior to his title reign, we saw this 170-pound title change hands quite a bit. Not so since he earned the strap. We'll see if he can keep it here tonight against the number one contender. Man, is he timing his shots well here tonight, DC. It's hard to recall him being this accurate in the past.
I mean, he is so sharp. And not only is he accurate, he needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, straight right. Against Brandon Wolf back in the day. A lot of knees, a lot of volume here. I'm not sure how many more he can take.
My boy John Anik is an encyclopedia of knowledge and threw it all the way back. But those knees will definitely take effect the longer this fight goes.
Going for submission.
Better than the concert. Nicely done.
All right, he's got the full mount now. Is this one of the most dominant positions in MMA? Is that fair to say?
It's a very dominant position. It's one of the most ideal positions you can get to, especially if you are fighting someone.
Right there as he lands, and maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
Pretty good strike there, but not a ton of meat on the bone. Kind of looks like me at the Boca Raton Boxing District.
He's used everything he could early in the fight, and now he's just in survival mode.
The strikes continuing to pile up. 27 total strikes have landed for Leon Edwards. Oh, that's going to soften him up. Massive knee to the body. Beautiful striking there by Leon Edwards. He has really become a well-rounded welterweight. You saw in the Gunnar Nelson fight how good his wrestling defense was. Oh! And just like that, the fight is over. All right, so without further delay, here we go. Round one is underway. This, the UFC welterweight championship, and there is the champion out of the red corner working his way to the center of the octagon. He has defended this belt in the past and believes if he can do so again tonight, and here and still, he could go down as one of the greatest 170-pound fighters in UFC history. In order to do just that, he has said, I've got to get off to a good start here tonight. We'll see if he attacks offensively here early.
Left hand punch from the clinch. Oh, nice.
Oh, straight right.
Big powerful punch land. Now he gets back in range.
That is a hard left hand that lands for Leon Edwards. And as usual, DC, let this fighting do the talking tonight.
Let this fight do the talking. This is all business. He's a businessman. He's here to win. Go back to England and do his thing with his family. He's not going to be on TV hooping and hollering. He's a guy that's here to do his job and then go back home until he gets out. And everything's landing with so much power.
Flush land to close out his opponent. I'm not even sure the other fighter saw it.